Welcome to Savvy IT Solutions. So now in the last video we are discussing about control structures introduction. In this introduction we explained in detail about what is why control structures and what is control structures and types of control structures. So under these we are learning the first part is decision making. Under these conditional control structures, under these decision making, under these simply put them first concept we need to discuss now. Okay, so in this video we are discussing about introduction to branching. So in the last video we discussed about the control structures. Under these control structures we have conditional control structures. Under these conditional control structures we have decision making or branching. Under this we have simple if, if else, nested if else and else if. So now we are purely discussing about simple if in this video. Okay, so now I am moving to the next level. So the syntax of simple if, if condition, this condition is true, then statements 1 and statements 2 are executed. If this condition is false, then only statements 2 will be executed. Okay, this is the meaning of the meaning. So the flowchart indicates if this condition yes, statements 1 statements 2. So this is for no. If this condition is true, then statements 1 and statements 2 are executed. If the condition is false, then directly the statement 2 will be executed. So some in few textbooks the diagram is represented in the diagram will the flowchart will be represented like this. Condition so both are correct, there is no wrong at all, but the way we are representing is different from one. The symbolic representation is same, no difference. Okay, and one more important thing is if this condition is true, then statements 1 and statements 2 are executed. If this condition is false, then only statements 2 are executed. That is the first point we need to make it at account. And the second point is the condition may be simple or complex. The condition may be either simple or complex. And the third point is here I am writing statements 1. If the number of statements are 1, option to use these brackets, curly brackets. If the number of statements are more than 1, mandated to use these brackets. That is what exactly the concept of simple if. Okay, if you know these points, that is enough for you to understand better. Now write a Java program to find the greatest of two numbers. I will not write entire program, I will write only the logic of behind this. Okay, so here greatest of two numbers, we need two numbers, so we need to reassign two variables. After that we need to read the values from A and B through either scanner class or buffer reader class or using command line argument. We need to read A and B two values. After that we need to do one thing, if A greater than B. So what we need to print, system dot out dot println is greatest. Again we need to check one more condition, that B greater than A. Again we need to print the message system dot out dot println, okay, B is greatest. Like this we need to solve the problem. So second program, check the given number is even number or not. Before entering into that, we need to know what is even number and what is odd number. If a number which is in a number which is divisible by 2 and the remainder 0 is called even number. The examples of even number are 2, 4, 6, 8, so on. So odd numbers are which divides with 2 and the remainder not equal to 0 are called odd numbers. There are 1, 3, 5, 7, 9, etc. So now our goal is to, if you read the value n, if n mod 2 is equal to 0, then we need to write system dot out dot println, okay, so n is even. Again we need to check one more condition, n mod 2 not equal to 0. These all are all the relations, relational operators we use it. N is odd. Like this we need to check it. Similarly, the next program is check the given year is leap year or not. How we define leap year? Every 4 years a leap year occurs. On that day the number of days is 366, otherwise 365 days. Okay, so that is what exactly the leap year condition. So we divide with 4, it remainder is 0, then it is called a leap year. Okay, so now we need to read y. If y mod 4 is equal to 0, okay, so system dot out dot println y is leap year. If y mod 4 not equal to 0, system dot out dot println y is non-leap year. So here in this way we are checking the conditions. So the next one is write a Java program to check the second number is factor of first number or not. What exactly the concept is? A is the first number and the second number is B. If the remainder is 0, then it is called a factor, otherwise not a factor. Okay, so if A mod B is equal to 0, system dot out dot println B is factor of A. Again we need to check one more condition, A mod B not equal to 0. So in this condition system dot out dot println A is not a factor of, sorry, B is not a factor of A. That is what exactly. So the next program is check the given number is positive number or not. How we can say a number is positive? If the number is greater than equal to 0, it is positive, otherwise negative number. So we need to check n is greater than equal to 0, we need to print n is positive. Again, if n less than 0, n is negative. So in this way we use simply function in better. Thank you.